My name is Dejan Abidoy. I'm a board-certified oncologist, and I've spent 2 decades treating patients firsthand, as well as designing clinical trials to develop new medicines. During this time, I've seen and treated several different types of tumors, none more challenging as colorectal cancer. Colorectal cancer is a pretty serious disease. It's the 3rd most common cancer worldwide, and it's the 2nd leading cause of death from cancers worldwide. In the metastatic setting, meaning when the cancer has spread from its original location, the median overall survival is approximately 1 year. Colorectal cancer starts in the colon or rectum, which are parts of the large intestine in the digestive system. It begins as small growths called polyps in the inner lining of the colon or rectum. Over time, some of these polyps can turn into cancer. Symptoms may include changes in bowel habits, blood in the stool, or unexpected weight loss. But sometimes, there are no signs at all in the early stages. And as a result, it's often diagnosed after the disease has spread. When we focus on Black individuals in the US, we also see data that indicates disparities as compared with other ethnic groups. Some of these disparities are driven by differences in access to care, cancer screening rates, representation in clinical trials, and socioeconomic factors. When compared with the rest of the population, Black individuals in the US are most likely to be diagnosed with colorectal cancer in the metastatic or advanced stage, less likely to receive high quality and timely screening, and 21% less likely to receive surgery for colorectal cancer. Despite some of the advances we've seen in other solid tumors, very little development has occurred in colorectal cancer. This represents a huge unmet need for a lot of patients, and it's an area where we can do a lot better.
In 2022, when I started to feel several symptoms that I have not felt before, I contacted my doctor and they treated my symptoms with different type of treatments, which was not working, and my situation was getting worse. After about a year, I feel fatigue, I feel weak, I feel bloated. I'm not going to the bathroom as normal. And when I spoke with the doctor, they wanted to treat me with all different other remedies and none of them worked. I think it's time for me to do my first colonoscopy. I'm ready for it. And I was thrilled, like, we're gonna take care of this. I will feel this no more, until I woke up from my colonoscopy and the doctor looked at me and my husband and said, I think you have cancer. The treatment plan was to start radiation for 5 days. After that, we started chemo treatment for 6 months. After that, they still seen the cancer in the rectal area, and they decided to go ahead and do surgery to remove the cancer. Once that was done, my doctors told me I'm cancer-free. But 3 months later, I went back for my CT scan and they said, hey, your cancer has metastasized to your lungs. The treatment plan was to go straight into a clinical trial. After that, we will see what's our next step.
My name is Michael Burns. I'm a medical oncologist by training, working in AbbVie's Oncology Early Development Group. As a physician scientist, my focus is to bring new scientific discoveries from the lab bench into the clinic. When colorectal cancer is diagnosed at a late stage, when the disease is metastasized or spread, median overall survival is approximately 1 year. But there's a need for additional treatment options. There's an opportunity to improve outcomes for patients with colorectal cancer by taking a precision medicine approach. Precision medicine makes use of specific information about a person's tumor to help ensure the right treatment is provided to the right patient. One key way to achieve this is through targeting of unique protein biomarkers in certain cancers via antibody drug conjugates, or ADCs. ADCs are designed to find cells by looking for that unique biomarker and then latching onto it to deliver a toxic agent called a payload to kill the targeted cells. By looking for these biomarkers, ADCs seek to selectively deliver their payload to cancer cells while trying to minimize the effect on healthy cells. As we work to discover and develop new medicines, our goal always comes back to the patient and how we can impact the care of challenging diseases like colorectal cancer.